Hi there, and welcome back to my channel. It's Carla of Tiny Eggy Crafts, and I'm here today to show you a little sewing project I did a couple of months ago. Well, the start of a sewing project I did a couple of months ago. It's a 1930s McCall's pattern. I'm very excited to show you the start of it. Okay, let's go. Thank you. So the pattern I'm currently working with is a McCall pattern 8087 from 1934. It's pretty cute. I really enjoy it. The person who originally used it cut it to view B, which is a short one, short sleeve one, left the sleeves in case they wanted to make view A. And I thought that was spectacular. But since it was already cut to view B, I decided to cut it in that one. Underneath it, I have my book where I mark off what I'm working on. Need to put in the alterations in the start date of yesterday, but that's a swatch of the fabric. And I just put a picture of the pattern, make down little notes, swatch, start and finish. That's about it. So, let's get cracking. So, as I was looking at this and looking at the instructions underneath, I noticed something strange. This is the center front. There's no buttonhole placement at all. Not even on the skirt. That's the sleeve. Center front, no buttonhole placement. I'm gonna have to wing this. So I decided to look into my old textbooks and thankfully found my 5th edition of Pattern Making for Fashion Design by Helen Joseph Armstrong. It's chock full of information on how to draft your own patterns, how to work from pattern blocks, etc. And the thing that's especially helpful is where to put your buttonholes. Now, I'll only show you a little snippet of the information that it has so I don't get hit with copyright infringement. So, here we go. For buttonhole spacing, mark the first and last buttonhole, then divide the remaining space among the remaining buttonholes needed. Can do. this Singer 99K is my pride and joy. I got her off Craigslist for a steal, basically. And she runs, well, like a sewing machine. She's amazing. I have yet to name her. If you have any naming suggestions, feel free to drop them in the comments below. Let's thread her. First thing it wants me to do is gather and make a lap seam, so right here. Thank you. what I'm going to do next is figure where the buttonholes are going to be spaced out at. I'm going to use this seam gauge, which can also be used as a buttonhole gauge. Figure out where the top button will go, where the bottom button will go, and then space the others within. Now that I've marked out the buttonhole placement, hopefully, here, see what Butterick's book has to say about bound buttonholes. It says, bound buttonholes are easily made. Follow this step-by-step method. Seems pretty easy enough. I have these scrap pieces of cabbage that I can use to make the contrasting bound buttonholes. So I'm going to measure these all out, cut them on the bias, and go to sleep, because it's 11:30 at night. Night-night. Thank you. Right now, I'm currently making covered buttons, such as this one right here. It's going to be a lot of them. Pray for what's left of my sanity, please. So I marked out all the bound buttonholes, and I'm about to sew them. To say that I'm terrified is an understatement. I've done bound buttonholes many times, but for some reason, this one's a little frightening. All right, I just cut in. No going back now. Then that's when school got a little more intense, and then everything else happened. But I'm gonna be working on it in a couple more weeks, so stay tuned for part two. Thank you very much. Have a lovely rest of your day. Take care.